I listened to your talk on YouTube. I think you are talking Ayurveda in a different language.
I have read only one Veda, sir, that is this one.
Inner exploration is very important. That is the place where Ayurveda is born. Mm. Hmm?
Namaskaram, all of you.
Namaskaram.
Everybody looks like a bank robber. I don't know who or
So the Ayur Prana is doing great work in the field of Ayurveda. They create Ayurvedic herbal product. We bring raw material from India, organically grown, no chemical pesticides, no chemical fertilizer. Then we test it here, see that there are no toxic heavy metals, arsenic, mercury, lead. And such a good work. They create churna, which is powder form, siddha tailam, medicated oil, siddha ghritam, medicated ghee, gutika, vatika, tablet. And boy, this Benny and Botanical and Ayur Prana, they are doing very good work in the field of Ayurveda. Mm-hmm. And so that Ayurveda is becoming quite popular in the Western world, both in America, England, Germany. An amazing thing, there is so much hunger for Ayurvedic clinical approach. So I teach them Nadi Pariksha. And in Nadi Pariksha, the basic Manduka Gati, Sarpa Gati, Lavaka Gati, Tittira Gati, Hamsa Gati, different Gatis are there. And with the grace of God, I am a good artist. I draw the picture of the pulse, how it looks. Mm-hmm. And we are doing webinars. And each Friday, some new subject, new topic, that how to determine Prakruti through the pulse, how to do the assessment of Vikruti, the present altered status of the dosha. Then through the pulse, we can understand the Manas Prakruti, Manas Vikruti, sub doshas, Pran, Vyan, Udan, Saman, all these sub doshas. And boy, there is so much demand. People love that. And to teach this subject in Zooming or on Zooming is quite an art. We have 2-3 cameras where I go near the camera and I just say, this is Vata Pigam, Adya Madhya Antyanadi. Adya Nadi, Vata, Madhya Nadi, Pitta, Antyanadi, Kapha. And then slowly, the spike under each finger, Vata Pitta Kapha, Vata Pitta Kapha. And when we go deep, Niguda Nadi, Prakruti Pradarshini, Uttanatu Vikruta. So, Muncha Muncha Dhrutva Dhrutva, hold it, leave it, hold it, and then you will come to that state, that spike. And you have to just pay attention to the kapha spike, pitta spike, vata spike. Under this 3 finger, how many vata spike, how many pitta spike you get, and based upon that, you can determine your prakruti. The deep level, the 7th level, is prakruti. And prakruti is your unique genetic code. It is your blueprint. It is still there, pulsating, throbbing under your radial artery. And amazing, people love it. So this work, Ayur Prana, is doing quite a fantastic work in the field of Ayurveda. Mm-hmm. And a couple of years ago, I was in Coimbatore also. Dr. Krishna Kumarji and Ram Kumar, they invited me to teach Ayurvedic art of... This is a lost art. No school teaches this ancient Vedic art of pulse assessment. And Krishna Kumarji, he loved it. He's such a holy person. And they have a big school there in Vaidik Raman. And they do Panchakarma there. And there were about 200 Ayurvedic doctors. They come there to receive this art of reading the pulse. It is art, but it is a science. And in Ayurveda, science and art can go together.
It is just that everything is put through the same microscope today.
Correct.
So if you say, I love somebody, they will check your blood and prove to you that you don't.
Correct.
So, all the subtler aspects of life, well, see, the grosser aspects of life manifest strongly. Studying them is one way. The subtler aspects of life, their manifestation is subtle.
Yeah, absolutely.
So for everything, if you say, show me where it is, you cannot… I cannot even show you the air that you breathe.
Correct.
Nobody can prove that you're alive, actually. There is no proof that there is life here. The heart is beating, but time will come when they will make the dead body's heart beat. It's not far away, I'm saying. They can pump the blood, they can make it work. So there is no proof that we are alive either. So in a way, this for everything gross physical proof will lead to a point where it's already happening, where life is not valuable, only the structures that we build is valuable. The fundamental life itself is not valuable. We are forgetting everything else that we built, the house that we built is only an accessory to our life. The clothes that we wear is only an accessory to our life.
Correct.
But these things have become bigger than life itself.
Absolutely.
That's the… So in a culture and atmosphere like that right now, it needs to get to its peak and go down.
Absolutely.
Till then, it's hard to convince people about the subtler dimensions. Beginning to happen, but still it's not mainstream.
That's beautiful.